Welcome to Vishwablom. So in this video we will be looking at AIM3 analytical geometry packages. So packages, first we will start with Perl package. So first what we have to do in this Perl package, first question is, so they have given us 3 points. What are the 3 points we will see? That is, A is 0, 0, B is 2, 5, and C is 7, 4. Clear? So what we have to do, we have to find the centroid G. So what is the value formula? Just in the challenges we have discussed, right? Last question, x1 + x2 + x3 / 3, y1 + y2 + y3 / 3. So what we have to do first, x1 value is 0, x2 value is 2 and x3 value is 7 / 3, comma y1 is 0, y2 is 5 and y3 is 4 / 3. So 2 plus 7 is 9 / 3, comma 5 plus 4 is 9 / 3. So 3 ones are 3, 3 ones are 3, 3 ones are 3. So answer is 3, 3. You will get it as option A. Okay. So completed first one. Now we'll see second. Now in the second question, they have given us A is 2, -3 and B is 5, 6. We have to find the x-axis for it. So what is x-axis formula? -y1 is to y2. So, right. So what is y1? So -3 is 2, y2 is 6. So this is plus, right? So minus into minus. So 3 ones are 3, 2s are. So answer is 1 is to 2, and it is option C. Okay, see, get it? I think now we will see third one. Now this question, they have given us A value as 6, 5 and B value as 2, 3. So they have given us midpoint also, that is 4, 4. I am writing MP, you are not supposed to write in your book. Then x is equal to what? We have to find that only. So here x is there, right? That one we have to find. So what is the formula for the midpoint? x1 + x2 / 2, y1 + y2 / 2. So what is x1? It is x, right? So plus x2 is 2 / 2, comma y1 is 5 + y2 is 3 / 2. So your point is also given, right? 4, 4. You should mention that also. Now, 4, 4 is equal to x + 2 / 2, 8 / 3. So 8 / 2 is nothing but 4, right? So mention it as 4. So these two values are equal. You saw that? Then these two values also should be equal. So we can equate them to find the, in order to find x value, right? So I equated them. Now x + 2 is equal to, now if I send that 2 to RHS, it is going to be 4 2s are 8. Then if I send this +2 to RHS, it is going to be 8 - 2, that is 6. So 6 make option C. Okay, now we have to see fourth one. So this is the fourth one solution. So first they have given us 3 points, P, Q, Q, 1, 1, P, and they have told that the centroid is origin. Origin means 0, 0. So we have to find PQ + QQ - 3PQ. Clear? So how to do that? I'll say now. So first we have used the centroid formula, that is x1 + x2 + x3 / 3, that is P + Q + 1 / 3. Then they are also in the same way, y1 + y2 + y3 / 3. So what we are supposed to do, these two should be equal, right? So see, this is both is same, only Q + 1 + P and P + Q + 1 is both are same. So I will be taking first equation equal to 0, I will make it. Now what I can find actually with this? 3 if I send to RHS, 0 into 3 is 0 only, then plus 1 if I center it becomes minus 1. So this is the thing, you have to box it and keep, but it's not the answer. Wait, so what is the answer means? Actually, we have to find what is this. For that, see, if I add one more, like if I make this minus plus, and if I add one p plus q in the here, then it becomes pq plus q cube, that is like a cube plus b cube. No, that formula we can use and do. So for that, what I'm going to do is pq plus q cube plus 3pq into p plus q equal to minus 1. Huh, where from this p plus q and all that? I just put p plus q and minus 1 I added, that's it. No change will happen to the equation. If I cut it, if I send this p by q there, nothing, it's going to be nothing. Okay, so no change I made. Huh? Then pq plus q cube, here this is plus, right? Now if I, this p plus q is minus 1 equal to minus 1. Clear? Now what it will make, p cube plus q cube, this one will be minus, this will be multiplied with this term only, right? So this will be 3 into minus 3 pq, that is equal to what? Minus 1. That's it. So I think you understood this one. So little bit tricky they went actually. So you don't think, why did I put this all? Because it's just to make it as a plus b, sorry, the formula, you know, right? A plus b whole cube, that formula, in order to make that only I have put. If I don't put, what I can do, you tell me? We can't help it out in any way if I don't put anything. So that's why I have put that there. Okay, so this is the fourth answer, and option I will give it, yeah, it is b. Now we'll see fifth one. But before taking fifth one, I would like to explain the first up. Before the fifth question, one line is there. Very much important. Based on that, only the three questions are given to us. So, that one given data, one figure I will be drawing. Okay. So, that figure I will be drawing now. Picture. So, it is a triangle they mentioned. 3 points and the midpoint they mentioned. So, we can understand it is a triangle. It is P, Q and R, the name, and P, they have mentioned that PQ is 3, 2. Where they have mentioned like that, you will be thinking it meant that STU is just to confuse us. They just PQ, R, that's it. So we will just take it as PQ, RP and QR. Okay, so this is 2, -1, and this will be 1, -1. Get it? So this is how they confuse us. So that's why you will get confused. Now fifth one we will see. So we have to find the vertex of P. So now sixth one they asked Q and seventh one R. So same way with this one diagram, I'll explain all the three questions. Okay. So the formulae, I have last note points once you recollect, or else if you are not able to recollect, go to the video and see. I'll keep all the remaining videos link if you want. Okay, so fifth one, P. What is the P for formula? It is alpha 2 plus alpha 3 minus alpha 1 comma beta 2 plus beta 3 minus beta 1. Huh, what is this betas now? You will be thinking, nothing. Alpha means x, beta means y. This is, that's it. Simple. Like x1, x2, we have alpha 1, alpha 2. That's it. Just to change, make you the formula clear. That's it. Now alpha 2 will be, so let's just see that it is 2 plus 3 minus 1. Comma. So this is the first side, this is the second side, and this is the third side. Get it? So as I say, raise it. Now the last one, then here beta 2 is minus 1 plus 2 plus 1. So what is the answer going to be? It is going to be 4, 2, option A. Now sixth question also I will explain with this diagram itself, because then only it will make it easy, right? So that's why formula. First is x1 plus x3 minus alpha. Sorry. Alpha 1 plus alpha 3 minus alpha 2, comma beta 1 plus beta 3 minus beta 2. Clear? Now, what is alpha 1? Alpha 1 is 1 itself plus alpha 3 is 3 and alpha 2 is 2, comma beta 1 is minus 1, beta 3 is plus 2 and minus beta 2, it is plus 1 because minus into minus makes it plus, that's why. Now when you do all the calculations, it is going to be 2 comma 2, option is B. Okay, now 7th one we will see. So it is to find the vertex R. So vertex R, how we are going to find? Alpha 1 plus alpha 2 plus minus alpha 3 comma beta 1 plus beta 2 minus beta 3, that is equal to what is the alpha 1 is 1 plus 2 minus 3 comma minus 1 plus 1 plus 1 minus 2, that is nothing but, let's move the camera back. That is nothing but 0 comma minus 4, option you will take it as C. So this is the answer for 5, 6, 7. I hope you understood it. It's just based on this diagram. So now we will see the remaining matrix match. So matrix matching, 8th question, right? So 8th question, what we have to find there? First I will read. We have to find the centroid for the triangle. So up all the values are given. So let me make a triangle first. Or else we'll just write the values. It's fine. No need to draw a triangle for this. Because it's not big matter. And C value is A, B. So this is the values for all that. So first, 8th question is to find the centroid for triangle ABC. Okay, so how to find that is same formula again. So for finding G, we have formula is x1 plus x2 plus x3 by 3. So what is x comma y1 plus y2 plus y3 by 3? Now what we have to write here? X1 is A plus x2 is 0 plus x3 is A divided by 3 comma. Now y1 is 0 plus y2 is B plus y3 is B divided by 3. Now here A plus A is 2A by 3 comma B plus B is 2B by 3. Options, it is option B from the matrix matching. Now 9th one we will see. So for the 9th one, what we have to find? We have to find the midpoint of triangle. Sorry, only AB midpoint we should find. Okay, so how to find that? We have to find that using x1 plus x2 by 2 comma y1 plus y2 by 2. So this is the formula used for that. Now, what is x1? It is A. And what is x2? It is 0 by 2. What is y1? It is 0. What is y2? It's B by 2. Now, what is this actually? If you remove all these zeros, 0 plus. Now, A by 2, B by 2. That's it. Simple, right? Now, this is option A. Clear? So, just write that A in middle. You should write the step, previous step also in your notebook. So this is the 8th and 9th. Now we'll see 10th and 11th. So 10th one is also finding the middle point for BC. But okay, so BC midpoint, how to find? It is by x2 plus x3 by 2 comma y2 plus y3 by 2. Why it is, before formula was x1 plus x2, now why it is like this means, here we will just take it as x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3. So in order not to confuse you, I have just written like this. So no need to worry. So x2 is 0 plus x3 is b, so 0 plus b is b only, b by 2, comma y2 is b. Sorry, I have made a mistake. So x2, what is it? 0. x3 a by 2, comma y2 is b plus y3 is also b by 2. Now here what we can do is 0 plus a, it is a itself, right? Then to b plus b is 2b. So a by 2, 2b by 2. So 2 to cancel. So it is a by 2 comma b. Option is d. Now we'll discuss the 11th question. Here we have to find the midpoint for AC. That means the formula would be x1 plus x3 by 2 comma y1 plus y3 by 2. Right, so here what we are supposed to do, x1 it is a, x3 it is also a, so a plus a we can write it as 2a by 2 comma y1 is 0, y3 is b, so 0 plus b is b, so I'm not writing it. Now 2 to cancel, right, so then it is a comma b by 2. Get it? So option a c. So with this we completed our pearl package. In the next video we will be discussing emerald package and diamond package. So do like, share and subscribe to Vishwa Blooms. Bye for now, and don't forget to click the bell icon.